right, step 11, the big one, the p-value. The p-value is a probability, right? It is a number between 0 and 1. It is always between 0 and 1. It's the probability that if the null is true, right, if the null is true, is what we're seeing in our sample data very likely, right? If the null is true, what is the probability that what I'm seeing in my sample data, what is that probability of it actually happening, right? So the p-value is the probability that if H naught is true, we would see the sample data we saw in our test just by chance alone, right? Because when you run an experiment, something has to happen. So we want to know the likelihood that what we saw happen would actually happen, right? Just through chance alone, just through random chance, random variation, sampling error, all of those phrases we can swap out with each other. Right? P-values are not the probability that you'd make an error. Okay, we've got alpha and beta for that. Anytime you want to get a p-value, anytime you want to bump from step 10 to step 11, you have to use some sort of CDF function. And we've used a couple at this point. We've used normal CDF and TCDF. And sometimes I've forced you to have to use normal CDF and TCDF instead of your calculator functions for hypothesis tests, all right? But every time you want to get a p-value, if you want to go from step 10 to step 11, use a CDF. And again, our CDFs are going to either be normal CDF, TCDF, chi-squared CDF, or FCDF, okay?